Hello everyone. Today I want to show you my multicolour selector tool. At the moment I've been just using the one pencil or pen or whatever coloured crayon or felt tip I had in this tool holder. And if I wanted to change colour, then I have to physically change the pen in the tool holder. So I thought, what's best to use than one of these pens that has lots of colours in? And so I've modified one of these multicoloured pens to go on my tool. The only extra I've had to do is add a motor to rotate the pen selector. This top rotates, and as it rotates, it selects whichever pen you want it to whichever pen you want it to use. At the back, it's got a cam on the back which fits onto the servo, and this then brings the pen up and down like so. The other thing I wanted to show is that you can actually use this using grbl with the servo modification. I don't use grbl, I write my own firmware and what have you, so I can put whatever I like onto my plotter. It doesn't really matter to me, but I thought I'd make it so that other people with grbl can actually use this, make it and use this type of pen. So what I've done is my plotter has a standard tool holder which basically I can quickly swap out whatever tool I want to do. I've done a load of other tools, so I'll put a link to my tools page. But basically, to swap out a tool, all I have to do is to remove the two linear rods from here, and then fit another tool in. So basically, this can go in like so. This can go back in there like so, and I can just fit the two linear rods. But because my plotter is not using grbl, I've decided to make a copy, which is just, well, can you see that? Yeah, there you go, copy of my tool holder. And I'm going to, because I need this servo, and I'm going to put it into this. The reason I've made a copy is because I want to show you that it can be run off grbl CNC Shield, and we can use the commands that grbl use to control it. So I'll just put this together. In the plotter. Right. Yeah, put the two clips on. That's what it'll be like inside the plotter. So I can actually show you it's actually working. So. As I say, I've wired it up to a CNC shield with grbl on, and we've got the connection for the servo signal and a connection for the motor signal This one I've wired up to the motor direction switch. So when we change the direction, you know, if we send a command to change the direction of the motor, then what it will do, it'll switch this motor on, which is I've put a little transistor on there, so it can switch the power to the motor. So what I'll do is I'll just bring up my little USB thing. Have I disconnected from that one? Right, yeah, so if I just bring up my USB, what we can see is we've got the it uses the M3 command with a setting. So we can have it at 180 or we can have it at zero. So which means I can position this servo at whatever position I want, but for the pen to work, it just needs to be up or down, basically. So if I just select the 180 and I send that, you can see that it sends the pen down. Can get that a bit better in shot. And then, so if I send that now the M3 with the setting at zero, it'll lift the pen up. And I'll just do that again. I'll select the 180 and down again. And then you can see at the end there that the pen's out. And I'll just do the zero again. And then the pen's up. Now, to select the different colours, then I've had to add this motor. This motor, which then rotates the carousel on the top to pick whichever pen it's going to shove out the end, basically. Now, the way to do that, it needs two commands. It needs the M4 to activate the direction pin on. Hang on, I'll just put it down. So we have a direction pin on the shield, which is used to select the direction of the spindle normally. And so what we do is you use the M4 to select reverse, anti-clockwise. So that activates this pin. But we don't want it activated constantly. What we need is we just need to activate it briefly. So what we have to do is we have to send an M4 and then an M3 signal zero. So basically we only switch it on for a brief moment. And what I've done is I have a switch inside here which is activated by the cam. So when it's in a position, when the switch is on, the switch will actually keep the motor running, and then when the switch turns off, it then stops the motor. So we just need to briefly start the motor until it releases the switch, and then the switch takes over. So then we actually then turn off the pin, and then as the cam comes back to the switch, it stops the arm at the correct position again. So basically it will only do it once. But using this serial monitor, I can only just turn it on, because by the time it's going to do it a few times, because by the time I get to turn it off, it'll have gone around a few times. But just to show you what happens, I'll just activate it using this serial monitor. So we'll do an M4, and there you can see the pin is active now. But to deactivate the pin, when I deactivate the pin, it will then stop. So what we do is we use them two commands to change a colour. So we do an M4 and an M3 SO to stop it straight away, and then it'll only just do one colour at a time. So we can demonstrate this. What I'll do is I'll bring up, we can minimise that, we don't need that. I'll bring up my plotter controller, and we'll connect with that. And what I'll do is I've just done a little bit of a script. So we've got the two commands to tell it to what mode it is in, and then we've got the M5 to basically turn everything off, and then we pause for 3 seconds. Then I check that I'll use the M3180 to bring it down. I'll pause for 3 seconds, and then I'll bring the M3SO to bring the pen up. So we'll go pen down, pen up, and then we'll pause again. And then when the pen's up, I'll do an M4 followed by half a second, and then an M3 to stop it again, and that should just make it change the pen once. And then we'll do another pause, and then we'll do the pen down, then we'll just pause again, and then we'll do the pen up, pause, and then we'll just turn all the motors off. So I'll run this script. So if we open that script, which is the change colour, and hopefully I'll just hold that a bit closer so we can see it all back to front. There we go. Right, I've got it now. And see how it goes. So we was pen down for one colour and then pen up. So obviously you can all you need to do is wherever you need a pen change, you just have to need to run basically this down to there. That's it. So we insert that script into every place that we need to do a pen change, and then every time and just use the M3 to bring the pen down. I hope you found that quite interesting. I'll do a video of it attached to my plotter, so we can actually see it draw something with different colours at a later date. But that's it for now. Thank you for watching.